Hello. I think you all know there are times in life where right and wrong are finely balanced on this very, very thin razor edge. And it could fall one way or another, and the right and wrong we're talking about may or may not have something to do with an incident you could have been involved in. And basically, my reputation is, or at least one segment of my reputation is almost in tatters. And I think the only way to solve it is to explain the situation, sort of lay out my case as if you are the jury. And then, you know, you can say whether I am this or not that. So it was a very simple situation. A few days ago, the sun has been out. We've had really great weather. I live in Amsterdam, by the way. And one second. Now, this is just cool, clear water. I drink a lot of it. It's quite free if you live in the Netherlands. I think in some places you don't have water, which is very sad. Anyway, that's what I drink. Just a sec. Yeah. So I'm out on my bicycle, just a regular citizen on a bicycle in the south of Amsterdam. And I'm cycling away. And because it's so warm and sunny, most people have this really good vibration. And so it's high, 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 you know, almost accidents instead of the usual cursing and swearing. It's like, oh, sorry, 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 that kind of thing. So it's just really great. So I'm cycling along. And I sort of turn this way, turn that way. And eventually I find myself on a street. And in the middle of my half of the street, so not the other half or the middle of the street, but the middle of my side of the street, I see a cat is dead, sort of on his back, feet up in the air. And I mean, it's very sad. I don't know the cat, but it's, I mean, a dead cat's always sad. Dead anything is usually, well, yeah, anyway, whatever. So I'm cycling, and I have to make a decision, because, as you know, a straight line is shorter than a swerve. And so I thought, given the environment, we need to take care of everything we have and use it really carefully. I didn't want to sort of have that extra swerve, those few extra millimeters of wear on the tires of my bicycle. So I decided, I mean, look, remember the cat is dead, or at least I thought the cat was dead, so I just went straight ahead. And just before my wheel went over the cat jumps up and gets away. I mean, I got the tail because I saw it was a bend. And the cat really starts screeching and squealing and accusing me of attempted murder, which really wasn't the case, because, of course, you can't murder what is already dead, and I'm not a murdering kind of person. But, of course, because of all this noise, all the cats in the neighborhood gather round. And, I mean, three or four cats is one thing. Well, you've got about 70 cats, probably around 95 cats, or about 120 cats just surrounding you. And one of the cats was a really mean cat, and I don't know if you can speak cat, but I do. And it's sort of basically saying, yo, what's up? And it was sort of really aggressive. And then this cat that I thought was dead said that I had tried to kill, murder it, that I'm trying to make my case and all that stuff. And yeah, look, the good thing is the sun was out and the cats didn't feel like getting nasty. So at least that helped. But they spread word, and it's still spreading, that I'm a sort of cat, I'm an attempted cat murderer. And given the facts that I've just laid out in front of you, think of it, do you see me as a simple elderly citizen cycling on his bicycle, thinking about the environment and therefore maintaining a straight line, or a ruthless wannabe cat murderer? You tell me. Thank you very much.